the garden keeps growing each year, so if you have in any way, shape, or form seen this garden before, even online, it looks completely different. So we started with around, I think the groundbreaking for this garden was on your birthday in 2013. That was just like the opening it up, like building beds and stuff like that. The first year that this garden like had a harvest was 2014, which is the summer that I came in. And we started with around 10 families. Now we have over 30. I think, I don't know, we might be pushing 40 because there's new families that are joining and sometimes it's hard to keep track. It really is because they just like come in and, you know. So we have around 30 plus families here. The majority of our gardeners are Mexican, are immigrants. Some of them identify as indigenous from Mexico. Some of them, Spanish is their second language. It's also very intergenerational, right? So when I mean families, I mean families. I don't mean like one person comes and gardening and this is their plot. I mean like the couple comes and they bring their parents and they bring their children and you have like 3-4 generations gardening together and keeping up and keeping the garden. So when I mean 30 plus families, like it's not 30 plus people, it's a lot more than that. So just to give you a sense of how many people are here, this is a very, very intergenerational space. So there are a lot of elders here, folks that have retired after many years of working under the table, of being exploited at work. This is their spot. This is where they spend a lot of their time. There's also a lot of women, a lot of moms, stay-at-home moms that garden here. And there's also a lot of babies. So we've seen a lot of babies grow up in this garden. And we've gotten an influx of also young people that are just interested in doing this work as well. So this garden doesn't necessarily, like, I guess, like, it doesn't cater to just one specific like age group. It really caters to like family settings because that's what the neighborhood looks like. The neighborhood looks like families, right? So as you see that we do like allotment gardens. One thing, the reason why I wanted to really emphasize that our garden, the majority of our gardens, the gardeners are people of color, are immigrants, is because something I've noticed in my kind of like my study of Chicago, my study of urban agriculture in Chicago, is that there a lot of the spaces where there is vacant land is in specifically in black and brown neighborhoods, but specifically in black neighborhoods, right? And that is due to white flight. So folks leaving and taking wealth and taking resources out of neighborhoods. So you have a lot of really beautiful neighborhoods that are completely, like there's all these like open land. So there's all these farms and all these community gardens in black and brown neighborhoods that are not run by people from the community, right? And I do wanna point that out because And that's not to say that there also are folks in their own neighborhoods doing their own work, and I want to definitely uplift that. But I think that urban agriculture can be such a beautiful thing and such an empowering thing, but it could definitely be a tool of gentrification and a tool of harm. And that's just, I remember we just hosted Leah Penniman from Soulfire a few weeks ago, and she said something like, the land is not the perpetrator, but the land was used to harm us. And I feel the same way about urban gardening in Chicago, right? Urban gardening is not harmful to actually grow a plant, but if you're occupying a specific neighborhood and you're not letting people from the neighborhood make the decisions, then that's a level of violence, it's slow violence, where people are not having access to things, right? So it's really, really, really important. I do think our gardening is really special, that we have like majority Spanish-speaking folks holding it down. And I would say I'm one of the coordinators, but like I do very, very little work compared to all of the work that the gardeners do every day. So they really are the reason why this garden looks so beautiful. So allotment gardens, some families have like a bunch of little beds, some families have little ones. We have a few